Former KZN Premier Dr. Frank Mdlalose will be laid to rest today in Newcastle, KwaZulu-Natal. He died of COVID-19 related complications on Saturday. He'll be honoured with a Category 2 special funeral. Tuba Vilani is covering the story for us. Tell us what's going to happen today, this morning, Tuba.
Jane, indeed, he was accorded with the Category 2 of the special funeral. You will know that Dr. Mdlalose, the former premier of the province, passed on Saturday, and we were told that, according to the IFP, his former party, they confirmed that he contracted COVID-19 and he died on COVID-19 complications. Throughout the week, we saw dignitaries coming, visiting the family of Mdlalose to pay their respect, and today where we are at the St. Andrew Anglican Church, that's where the service is going to take place. But we understand that beside the place where we are, there are also going to be screens that have been erected across Newcastle so that mourners will be able to follow what is taking place here. I'm joined by the provincial spokesperson, Lennox Mabaso, just to understand more on what is expected to happen today. But Mabaso, thank you so much for your time. Just share with us. I understand that this is a very short program. What one can expect?
Well, it is indeed a very brief program to pay the final respect and to lay to rest one of the most decorated leaders of the province of KwaZulu-Natal. As you have indicated, the Premier of KwaZulu-Natal, Premier Sithezekalala, wrote to the President to request that he be granted a fitting honor. And the President has bestowed the late Dr. Frank Mdlalose, our first democratically elected Premier in the province, with a special official provincial funeral category 2. So what will be happening is that there are two parts to this program. We will be joined by Premier Sithezekalala, who will deliver the eulogy at the end together with the other leaders that will be giving tributes today. The first part of the program is going to be a program whereby there's going to be a church service. There's going to be a ceremony that will be performed by the leaders of the Anglican Church. And then that will be followed by the formal program, and then which is the second phase, and then the third phase is going to be the actually laying to rest. Of course, as you know, a funeral of this nature, if it's an official, special official funeral, it will also involve some ceremonial activities by the South African Police Services, because it's category 2.
How to ensure that we still adhere to regulations, as we understand that we're still under lockdown?
You will notice that as the Director General of the province, Dr. Nondata Mkhize, was leading the logistical preparations, part of the issues is to ensure that the strict adherence to COVID-19 protocol, there will be about 100 people, no more than 100 people in this particular venue. If you enter there at the gate, for instance, you get sanitized, you get screened, all the protocols are adhered to. The head of the Department of Health in the province is also here to ensure that there is no compromise. Also, the MEC for Health is arriving now to also ensure that there is no compromise when it comes to adherence to the regulations, and the SAPS will also monitor that. So there's been a lot of preparations and efforts, but also because we know that we're laying to rest a leader of the people of KwaZulu-Natal, there's been arrangements to make sure that people are able to follow through various streams on the online platforms, but also the public broadcaster, the SABC, will also be providing live coverage.
Thank you so much. That was the provincial spokesperson, Lennox Mabaso, confirming that they are doing whatever they can to ensure that they adhere to lockdown regulations. We are expecting, I'm seeing dignitaries starting to arrive here, as he said. I'm seeing the Director General of the province. People are starting to stream in here. We're expecting that the service is going to start anytime soon.
All right. Thanks very much for that, Tuba.